Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about mission control and specifically getting that mission control plugin in Eclipse. If you're in Eclipse, the only one you can install right now is version 6, which is Oracle's, which requires a commercial license. I'm going to show you how to get the open source adopt OpenJDK one installed so you don't need that commercial license at all. Right now, if you try and install Java Mission Control in Eclipse, you'll be installing version 6, which is Oracle-owned and doesn't allow you to do flight recordings unless you have a commercial license. So the best way to get the latest version of Java Mission Control is to build it from the OpenJDK. And that might sound intimidating, but if you've got Maven and Git installed, it's not that hard. All you have to do is go over to the Java Mission Control GitHub repository. It's not on Mercurial anymore. It's over on GitHub, and copy that URL. You'll see the green button there. You copy the GitHub URL, and then you come to a folder on your local file system. I got a folder here called tutorial. I'm going to open up the git bash shell. Then I'm just going to clone that repository. Just git clone that repository URL in there, and all of a sudden that repo will get cloned to my local machine. Now there's a couple of interesting folders inside of this repo. One of them is this RELENG third party folder. There's a bunch of third party libraries that you need to build in order to get the Java Mission Control, Java Flight Recorder plugin working. So you have to come into this folder here, and then you just do a quick MVN p2:site, which is going to kind of set up a whole website that's going to host a Maven repository with all these third-party libraries at the core build of the Java Mission Control, Java Flight Recorder tooling is going to need. So yeah, so that command was Maven p2:site. Now I'm actually just going to host that site on Jetty. So I say Jetty:run. And this is all configured to host a Maven repository on localhost 8080, which is going to give the core build of Java Mission Control, Java Flight Recorder Eclipse plugin access to the third-party libraries that it needs. Okay, so you leave this open. Right now there's a Jetty server running on localhost 8080. You got to leave that open. If you close that window, that's going to stop the server and that's going to stop your Maven build. What we need to do is we need to go into this JMC folder again. That's where we did the clone. And we have to go into this core folder. And from this core folder, we need to do another build again. So I go git bash here. And then what are we going to do? We're going to do a Maven clean install. And the install command covers compile, test, and package. So it's going to compile the code, run some tests, and then package all of the core stuff up into appropriate jar files. And you can see in the output there, it actually says that certain jar files are being generated. Okay, and once all of that succeeds, I need to move from that core folder, cd dot dot, down to the base JMC folder. You can see I move folders there. And then the last command that I need to do is Maven package, which is going to take everything that's been built in that previous Maven install and then slice and dice and package it up into the various jar files that I need. One of those jar files is going to be the Java Flight Recorder Maven plugin. And there we go, the build has completed, and there's a very special file that's been placed on the folder system. So I'm going to go back to JMC here. You'll see this folder called application. I'm going to have to dig right down, org, OpenJDK, JMC, update site, where is it, JMC, oh, it's alphabetical, so you would be at the bottom. There it is, right there. Inside that target folder, and there we see the org OpenJDK update site IDE. That is the Java Flight Recorder Eclipse plugin version 8 that needs to be installed in Eclipse. So what we do is we head over to Eclipse, I go help, I go install new software, and then I click add, and I say I want to add from an archive. Now I got to go and find that thing again. Where is it? It was over in C, tutorials. Not temp, but tutorials, JMC applications, right at, don't drag, right at the bottom. under update site, IDE, target, and right there is the Java Flight Recorder, Java Mission Control, Eclipse plugin. I click open to install it. I click add. There's a few options here. I'm going to select all three, click next, click finish, accept any of the license agreements that might be required, click finish. That's just going to take a moment to install, and then I need to reboot my Eclipse IDE. I'm going to install, even though the software might not be signed. I will restart now. And now that Java Mission Control Eclipse plugin should be installed and ready for use on reboot. And there it is, right over here. We can actually see the Java Mission Control icon. It's asking me if I want to open up my firewalls. I will allow access. Then I can create a new connection, even go onto something local. I think I've actually still got that Jetty server running right there, so I can start a flight recorder and maybe record for, 1 minute. And now you can actually see the flight recorder is happening. And in 1 minute, I will actually have my first flight recording that I can look at with Mission Control. And there you go. We actually can see the flight recorder analysis here. We can take a look. It looks like I've got too many processes running on my machine. You can take a look at the memory that was used, if there was any garbage collection that happened or class loading, all of the threads that were in use and were blocked, the memory, the file socket, I/O, and everything like that. And there you go. That's how you get the Java Flight Recorder, Java Mission Control plugin installed in Eclipse. And there you go. That's how you install Java Mission Control in Eclipse. Now, if you enjoyed this tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com? I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got all sorts of great content on Java, Eclipse, enterprise software development, DevOps, you name it. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on the YouTube.